Coming up today in, about an hour and a half, Sarah Palin is going to be joining us.
We're going to talk to her about that horrible battle between the two of you for the 5 o'clock time slot.
Yeah. This is great. Oh, just real quick, inside baseball stuff. Yesterday, there was this big story from insiders. I don't know who these insiders are at Fox
News. They have such good information.
But they do. They have great information.
They know what's going on in your mind because we never talked about this. I'm with you almost every minute.
Right. Insiders at Fox News say that Glenn Beck is
inside
paranoid
his head.
That Sarah Palin is going to take over his 5 o'clock time slot. Can I tell you something? I am so paranoid that Fox just doesn't want the number two cable show on television, that they're just gonna, working out. It's historic ratings for 5 o'clock. I think we're gonna get rid of it and try something new. I'm very paranoid about that. And they're worried that first the story was last week that insiders were saying that I fought inside to make sure I got the Sarah Palin interview.
Mm-hmm.
I'm the guy who passed up a Sarah Palin interview when her book was out.
Yeah.
Did anybody notice that she wasn't on the show when her book was out? You think that was like an oversight? They were like, oh, crap. I forgot to ask about Sarah Palin. I am not that guy. I don't really care that much. I'm not into breaking the news. I'm into explaining the news. If there's something different I can say, we'll cover it. If everybody's saying the same thing, why do I need to do it? So then I do this hour-long interview last week with Sarah Palin where I'm ridiculed because apparently I almost threw her down and French kissed her. It was such a bad interview. It was such a softball. I thought they were going to make out at one point. But then, like, 2 days later, apparently I hate Sarah Palin because she's going to take my time slot.
And she's a powerful woman. You're a paranoid guy. You're afraid of everything. So, of course, you're afraid of her.
I'm afraid of her.
She's got her eye on that 5 p.m.
I have to ask her. She's going to be on today. I have to ask her, would she categorize us as friends? Because I don't want to ever speak out. I mean, you know, I don't want to say we're friends and have her go, no, we're not. But would you consider, I mean.
I would.
Yeah, okay, I do. I would. But I don't want to speak for her. I think we're friends. So, So anyway, so that was the story. When somebody at Fox called this reporter and said, what are you guys, stupid? Now the story is,
ready?
Now the story is, you're right. That's ridiculous. Glenn is actually trying to go after Bill O'Reilly's 8 p.m. time slot.
Which makes perfect sense.
It does.
You're killing him with kindness by going out on tour with him beginning this weekend.
It's all a trick.
It's all a trick.
You're buttering him up. He hates me.
You're going to stab him in the back.
Yes. Yes.
Because.
Yes.
Yeah, that's how you are.
I'm launching a major tour with Bill O'Reilly this weekend. It's sold out all across the country, and I'm only doing it to lure him in.
Mm-hmm.
Bring him in and then myrtleate him.
Well, keep your friends close and your enemies closer.
On stage with you as business partners. That's the way I like to do it.
But anyway, Sarah Palin's on the show at 11.
Yeah.
Just after 11 this morning.
And I don't want to talk. We're not going to talk about that. I want to talk a little bit about what happened in Massachusetts, a little about the delusional thinking of Barack Obama. But also, I want to ask her, did you notice that she's stumping for John McCain?
Yeah, I was really disappointed to see that.
It was like 1 a.m. This morning. And I read that and I sent her a note and said,
what are you doing?
What the hell are you thinking? So I'm anxious to hear what her response is.
She hasn't said anything back?
I don't think so. I haven't checked in a couple of hours. She's usually up, I don't know, shooting wolves and kickboxing. She wrote me one day. It was like 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock in the morning, you know, Alaska time, I think. I don't even know what time it is up there. It's always dark. And she's like, yeah, I just got out of kickboxing, and we're going to go hunting this morning. Like, you realize you can buy meat in grocery stores now, right? Last night I wrote her on something and I said, you know, you're probably out kickboxing and shooting wolves. And she writes me back last night, and she's like, all the wolves are dead now, and I put the rifle back underneath the bed. So I'm ready to go, you know, for the radio show tomorrow. I can't figure out what she's doing on that.
We got to ask.
He's a progressive.
Yeah.
And is it just me? But I don't think he and his people treated her well.
No. She might feel some sort of, you know, obligation
to him.
Get
over that.
Sense of obligation.
Maybe you should have obligation to the Constitution.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And then
everybody thinks, oh, she's just a dummy. They all dismiss her. You know what? She is so shrewd that I'm not sure. I can't ever say, well, that's just the dumbest thing I've ever heard. He's going out and stopping for John McCain. She's so shrewd. She may be doing something that I haven't figured out. You know what I mean? She may be doing something that's like, my gosh, maybe she's luring Bill O'Reilly in. Maybe
or John McCain.
Maybe she wants his 8 o'clock time slot. So anyway, we'll ask her coming up in about an hour and a half.
So there's also she's also apparently going to campaign for Bachman and Rick Perry. There's another guy she probably doesn't know all that well. I mean,
I think she does. You know what? She's
Governor's Council together, so maybe they know each other really well. Yeah. I've seen him together on a few occasions, so she might know exactly who he is and what he's all about. I mean, Rick Perry's fooled a lot of people, but
I don't know. We'll ask her because I don't know. Yeah. You know, she understands the Cloward and Piven. She's one of the only people that have come out and like quickly said, you know, I've had politicians that are like, yeah, well, you know, it looks like that and blah, blah. I mean, when I said, do you believe that they are intentionally trying to collapse the system, Cloward and Piven? And she said, oh, yeah. Yeah, I do. There's no other way to explain it because they're not this stupid.
She didn't really equivocate on that.
No, not at all. No. I mean, she's there, and I just have to figure out how she's tying all of these things together, and we'll do that. And, you know, the other thing is I'd really like to hear, I'd just love to hear her explanation on
why she's trying to stab you in the back.
Yeah, well, that.
You know, that. Why are you trying to take my 5 p.m. slot?
You know, the one thing that she said to me the other day, she said, you know, I'm really just, while everybody else is doing it, I'm really watching Barack Obama. I'm watching his every move. So I'd love to hear her idea on what she thinks he's going to do now. He is really in trouble. Mm-hmm. You see that AFL-CIO came out and said, now is the time. Now is the time that Barack Obama cannot back off. He's got to move forward.
Well, it's that whole every time you get into trouble, you don't slow down, you accelerate. It's the Saul Alinsky theory.
You see Frank Rich? Was it Frank Rich or we don't even get the times here in the studios. It was either Frank Rich or Paul Krugman. I think it's Rich that said today, I'm beginning to think that Barack Obama is not what he told us he was, that he doesn't have the spine to actually follow through and fight for these things.
I hope that's true. I don't believe that.
Wow.
I don't believe that for a second. I mean, they might not, they're not in the position where they can make all this stuff happen. They want it to happen, but they don't understand how difficult to fight. These people are in such a tiny, tiny minority in this country that when you want to completely overhaul the U.S. Constitution, you're going to have a fight on your hands.
What is the